Yeah, well, the environment doesn't make the mind. The reaction to the environment makes the mind. So there, it shows the strength of tendencies that, though they're unveiled in utopian situation, old tendencies persist. And that's a good example of unveiled but distorted. And we too. I mean, even if we're in sixth density or whatever, four, five, six, we're not finished. We're not a Buddha. We're not out of the octave. We still have distortion, imbalance, ignorance. The last kleshas remain, or the 10, 10th, 9th, 8th fetter, selfhood, conceit, and restlessness, basic restlessness of mind, or electromagnetic or pranic about restlessness, and basic avidya, avidya, ignorance, these three persist even in sixth density, for sure, let alone mid-astral plane. And so, yeah, it gives us a sense of how significant the work is of getting out of distortion in third density. Or how difficult it is for a lot of souls here to get out of third density, because even there, in Nosalar, there are all sorts of distortions, and I do think that the movie probably sugarcoated a bit, meaning they're not all smiling all the time, and if you see them at the dinner table, right, drinking their soup, which seemed kind of austere to me. They were smiling. And sort of in a loving way, but that wasn't quite fully honest. If you look closely, maybe it's the actors, but they're not in bliss or anything. They're not like walking around in joy. And even in Astral City, why should you feel joy? Well, you could feel joy, but it's impermanent too. Joy is impermanent. States of mind are impermanent. And so you're walking in a beautiful city with wide boulevards, flowers everywhere, trees, radiant music coming and going, beautiful fragrant flower scent in the air, and everybody is strolling along leisurely. There's no crime, there's no oppression, there's no economic privation, meaning they can get what they want, but they have to work. And that takes time, and therefore they have desires, and then they have people back on Earth, and then they have work to do, and then they have all these past lives that they're not even looking at fully because there's a lot of stuff there they're not even ready to look at, as we see in certain chapters. So that's a good window on what 3D distortion unveiled looks like. Unveiled, living in an unveiled condition, yet with persistence of common distortion. Creation, or the seven-dimensional octave, as a vast realm for path work experience, or experience. Free-willed experience and its consequences, experience being the consequences of past causes, in which there's a piece of work to do, or continual work of some sort required, even though rest and play are part of the balance. And that perspective, like Brent said, endlessness. And responsibility and work and this increasing spiritualization of our sense of what life's all about, increasing spiritualization of the meaning of life and the conduct of life applies to all of us and is really quite sobering, I think. So it also gives us just a better appreciation for for again, collective and individual 3D consciousness, and hopefully we can be more compassionate or heart open being with them as they are, and not expect what cannot be. You know, we often are disappointed and frustrated and angry and upset because we expect our preferences rather than expect what is. We don't see what is because we focus on what we prefer or seek, and get upset because what is doesn't accord with what I want. So, anyway, it's been a great journey, I think, this last 15 weeks, and I think we all did we all deserve some congratulations for staying with it and supporting it in our own ways. Right. Yeah, I've always said that our problem is not really with them, but with us being here with them. And that comes back to us acknowledging we chose to be here. Why do we choose to be here? And that's just a sort of deeper matter. Right, right. That's too much. The glare is sort of wisdom without adequate love. And we have to guard ourselves against that, for sure. Very much also in line with Ra saying that there's a real concern or danger for people who are increasing positive polarity or growing in power to make sure that that power is not inadvertently used in ways that depolarize us, meaning acting without adequate love, wisdom, balance. And so that may be too much love or too much wisdom. Right, 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 right. It's not freedom encouraging, or it doesn't encourage freedom, or it doesn't respect their freedom. It's called infringement. So depolarization, our positive path depolarization comes from infringement. And that infringement may obviously be done unconsciously or unwittingly, meaning we're not trying to hurt them, but we may have frustration, and so we end up a little bit forcing wisdom or information on them. It may also come from sadness, that under the frustration is sadness, that it's so painful that there's so much I know that no one can get. I feel that often. 80%. But, you know, it takes time, right? I mean, me too, right? I mean, I could be more evolved than I am, and however I'm not, is the result of not working through blockages or subtle imbalances and distortions. And so we all have our own works to do. And we persist in attachments because we use them as a crutch. We all do. And they're very hard to identify. And even when we identify them, it takes a while to fully get on board the truth and the feeling, sense, conviction that dropping this is better than keeping this. You know, it's easy to say, it's not that easy, but it's easier to acknowledge our distortions than to drop them, because dropping them or not feeding them really requires a whole being appreciation that keeping it now, the consequences of keeping it now are far worse than the consequences of letting it go or not feeding it and being without it. It's a faith and trust that I truly believe that being without this will be better than my current condition as the result of remaining with it or keeping my attachment to it. That takes time, you know? That's a big deal, right? That's a very important point. It's like going from being a senior in high school to a freshman in college. That's really an excellent point, that the person has to have sufficient self-esteem to fully have conviction, a sincere conviction, that the relative benefits of my familiarity and comfort with my current way is far inferior to the expected benefits of beginning again and learning some completely new ways, which may include new view of reality, from accepting these greater ideas and an expanded view that I'm not familiar with that much at all, and I become basically a beginner and thought that I was finished, but I see I'm only just starting. I'm a senior in high school, and everybody looks up to me, and I know a lot, and I feel like I've achieved something. I've gotten to the highest point in this system, but reality is I haven't even started, or I need to just begin to start the next phase in which I really will, in which I'll see I have a lot to learn, and I don't know that much, actually. That's a hard transition to make. Without adequate self-trust and with a lot of self-trust, really, and a clear sense that continuing my current way is worse than taking this new way, which I don't know much of, and whose consequences I also don't know too well. But somehow I have a trust or faith that I'll be better off in the new than I am now with the old. That's a big deal, actually. So, good. Yeah, I'm just sitting alone here in the forest in the mountainside, and just letting the rain fall. If you don't evolve voluntarily, you'll be forced to evolve kicking and screaming. Yeah, well, the point is, if we cannot evolve by cannot evolve within or by use of harmonious catalyst, then higher self, indeed, and the law of karma inevitably will set up conditions of traumatic or disturbing or difficult, challenging catalyst by which we end up giving ourselves no choice but to evolve. That's just the way it goes. So anyway, well, thank you for being here, and good questions as always. I hope you're all well. See you next time, and good night.